Hi friends, welcome to Citykidz. I'm so glad to have you here for today's lesson. Can you spell? Oh, can you spell Jesus? Let's go. What's the first letter? And the last one, S. Well done. J-E-S-U-S is the best. Who is the best? Jesus. All right, let's worship Jesus together because He is the best. Have you ever been in a boat or a ship? Oh, Paul must have traveled a lot in a boat. And in our Bible story today, God protected Paul while he traveled. Let us find out more about this story from your teacher.
Hi friends, how are you? How are you doing? How is mommy? How is daddy? How is everyone at home? Hope you're okay. Alright. Well, today, a storm. Well, today we are going to be seeing how God kept Paul safe even in the storm. Are you ready? Are you ready? Let's go.
Hey everybody, I'm Megan and I am Jesse. Jesse, how was your trip to the beach? It was awesome. I'm so glad.
Yeah, we played putt-putt, we made sandcastles, we swam in the ocean.
Wow, that sounds so cool.
My dad even took me out on a sandbar in a kayak.
That's amazing. In today's Bible story, Paul was in a ship in the ocean, and the ship ran up on a sandbar.
Fun! Did they get out and play?
Actually, it wasn't fun at all. The ship got stuck and started breaking apart.
Oh no!
But God protected Paul and all the other passengers. Listen to the story. Paul was a prisoner, and he was going to Rome to see Caesar, the emperor of the Roman Empire. Paul got on a ship with other prisoners going to Rome. But a big storm made the journey difficult. Strong winds, waves, and rain pushed the ship up and down. All the people on the ship were afraid they would die. God sent an angel to Paul. The angel told Paul to not be afraid. God was going to keep everyone on the ship safe. Paul told the other people on the ship what God had said. "Be brave," he said. "I believe God is telling the truth. We will be safe, but we have to get the ship onto an island." The ship got close to an island, and some of the sailors tried to escape in a lifeboat. Paul told them to stay on the ship if they wanted to be safe. The sailors listened to Paul. Now, everyone was really hungry, so Paul told them it was time to eat. He thanked God and broke the bread, and everyone ate. Then they sailed closer to the island. All of a sudden, the ship hit a sandbar in the water and got stuck. The waves crashed into the ship, and it began to break into pieces. A soldier in charge told everyone to swim to the shore. Anyone who could not swim clung to the pieces of the ship. Everyone made it to shore. Paul was right. God had kept all of them safe. 3 months later, Paul got onto another ship and went to Rome. He was still a prisoner, but instead of going to jail, Paul was allowed to live by himself in a house. A soldier stayed with him to guard him, and people came to Paul's house to visit. Paul taught people about God's kingdom and about Jesus, and some of them believed. Paul trusted God's promise to keep him and everyone else safe from the storm. He told the sailors to trust God too. God wants us to trust Jesus. Jesus died to keep us safe from sin and death. We can tell this good news to everyone.
Welcome. Did you like the video? Did you listen to the video? Okay. Well, Paul was a prisoner, and he had other prisoners with him too, and they were going to Rome to see Caesar. And while they were on their way, something happened. Do you remember what we heard that time? The storm we heard that time? Exactly. That was happening. And they were all scared. They were shaking. They were afraid. And you know what happened? The angel of the Lord came to Paul and he told him, "Be brave. Everyone on the ship will be safe." Yes. The angel of the Lord told Paul that they will be safe. And so you know what Paul did? Paul told everyone on the ship that God had told him that everyone will be safe. And they all believed. And while they were on the ship, some sailors tried to run away. They wanted to run away. But Paul told them that they should not go anywhere, but everyone who will be on that ship will be safe. And as they were all on the ship believing God, they were now hungry. They wanted to eat. And Paul told them that yes, they could eat. And so Paul prayed. And as they were eating, the ship hit a bar. Boom! And waves of water started pouring inside the ship. Have you seen those pirates movies? How water will be entering the ship? Exactly. That was how it was happening. Water was coming inside the ship. And before they knew it, the ship started to break. It was breaking. And the sailor told them, "Everyone who can swim, please jump into the water and let's swim." And so they all started to swim. And the people who could not swim, they held a stick and then they were able to get to the shore. You see, every single person was saved. Just as how God had told Paul. God wants us to trust Jesus. Just like Paul did, he trusted God to to be able to take him to where he was going, and even not just him, but everyone on the ship. God wants us to trust Jesus because Jesus Christ died and he resurrected to keep us safe from sin and death. He wants us to tell this good news to everyone that Jesus Christ is the Savior from sin and death. So every time you have an opportunity, please tell your friends that Jesus Christ died for them and he rose again to save them from sin and death. Are we excited? Are you promising me you're going to trust Jesus? Yes, good. We should always, always trust Jesus. I have a song, a very short song to teach you. Are you ready? I can hear you. Are you ready? Good job. Jesus stops the storm. Jesus stops the storm. Jesus can do anything for me. Jesus stops the storm. Jesus stops the storm. Jesus can do anything for me. Let's pray. Our Father and our God, we want to thank you for today's lesson. We want to thank you because you're always going to help us to trust you, even when we do not see any sign that you're going to help us. But we believe that you always help us. Help us to tell our friends and everyone around us that you love us and that you love them. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen.
That was a wonderful Bible story, right? Paul trusted God's promise to keep him safe and everyone else too. He even told the sailors to trust God. God always wants us to trust Jesus. Now, what are some ways we can trust Jesus? We can trust Jesus to keep us safe, to protect us and protect our family. We can trust Jesus to provide for us. And we can trust Jesus to help us say no to sin and to obey God. All right, so before we leave, as you know, we can't leave without saying our memory verse. Can you remember what our memory verse last week was? I'll give you a clue. Philippians 1 verse 6. Well done. All right, so let's recite it together. He who started a good work in you will bring it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. All right, I'm going to take it slowly so we can say it together. Let's go. He who started a good work in you will carry it, come on, roll, will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ. We can always trust God to help us as we follow Jesus. And make sure you follow Jesus this week. All right, have a wonderful week. Bye.